Alright guys, we're back staring at my engine bay, and in this video we are going to talk about the infamous CDB309 fault code that is plaguing B58s everywhere. Now some of you might just be finding this video because your car started misfiring or it has a check engine light, and so you scanned for codes and you found this one. And a lot of times in your tuning software it just says no description, so it's kind of hard to see what the fault code is for. So you might be quickly just trying to look it up and see if this is something important. Now, if you're knee deep in your car trying to solve a problem, I don't want to waste your time. I'll tell you right now, this isn't your problem. This isn't causing your check engine light. So go ahead and look elsewhere. But if you have a little bit of time, we're going to go ahead and talk about me digging way deeper than I probably need to into this fault code, just because I was curious. So like I said, the CDB309 fault code is something that a lot of B58s seem to have. When you scan your car, you see this code kind of in the background and you don't really know what it means because a lot of times tuning software just shows it with no description. Now, here's a little bit of free game for those of you guys that don't know. If you ever have a fault code that your tuning software doesn't actually have a description for, you can simply go to bmwfault.codes. Type in your 6-digit BMW code and it'll show all the information and description for the code the exact same way that it would if you had the actual BMW diagnostic software. So this works for anything, engine codes, chassis codes, anything that you might see in a scan on your car. So just something to help you out in the future. But as you can see, the description of this code is basically indicating that there's some kind of issue in the communication between your HVAC system and your DME. So it says that it's coming from the IHKA, and I'll put the acronym down at the bottom, but it's basically German for climate control. So sending data from the climate control system to the DME is causing a fault. Now, I don't know exactly what causes this code in our scenarios. I think it's something linked to our tuning software, and a lot of people see this after they tune their cars. It kind of comes and goes. So I think it has something to do with the way that it unlocks the DME or flashes the car. It basically causes this code. Now, most of you know that even though you have this code, your AC works perfectly fine. All of your automatic heating functions work. So there's probably not really anything wrong, but I'm in the middle of diagnosing the problem with my 340i. As you can see, I've got it all taken apart and I decided to scan it with ISTA. And of course I saw this code in the background. So my curiosity got the best of me and I decided to see what would happen if you brought this to BMW and a mechanic tried to fix it. So here's what the code looks like when you scan the car in ISTA. Again, it just kind of shows that it's sending data from the climate control module to the DME, and it seems like it's not getting a message. So based on all the information in here, it's assuming that there's some kind of wiring issue. Either something's not plugged in, a wire's broken or shorted, and preventing the message from being transmitted properly. Now it does say that there is a rare case where it could actually be the module itself failing, but it definitely doesn't think this is likely. And if you do think that it's the control module failing, especially in a warranty situation, you have to put extra information in the comments for the warranty repair in order for it to actually be approved. So even BMW is getting kind of skeptical that this is really a problem. Now the other thing that it says is typically this fault is thrown multiple times. So every time data is trying to go back and forth between the DME and the climate control, it should throw this fault if there's actually a problem. So I can't remember the actual wording, but I'll show it on the screen here. It basically says if it only throws the code once and the customer isn't complaining about it, then they're not going to approve you doing any repairs on the car. So even BMW at this point is just telling you to ignore it. But again, my curiosity is getting the best of me. I don't want to ignore it. So I'm going to go ahead and go through the test plan to see how a mechanic would actually try to diagnose this fault. Now, based on the information in here, they're basically showing that you need an oscilloscope in order to actually properly diagnose it. And you're going to just check all of the connections and make sure that there's continuity and power and that it's actually seeing a signal being sent between these connections. I don't have an oscilloscope, but I still like clicking around through ISTA just to see if it can give me any obvious tips or things that I can look at to try to figure it out without the special tools. So I went ahead and clicked on the option where it checks for like the most common faults. That didn't really show me anything. Then I went ahead and started going through the other option. And again, it indicated that if you're not actually experiencing an issue, this is something that should be ignored. So I really just think that this isn't a real problem. This is something that BMW puts in there in case it could cause an issue. But 9 times out of 10, it seems like even they agree and believe that this isn't something that needs to be fixed. So yeah, that's kind of what I found as I dug into it. I know I didn't do full diagnostics to try to figure out if there's a problem, but that's mostly because I know that I'm not having an issue, and I highly suspect 99.99% of you are not having an issue either. This is just something that we tend to see after tuning our cars or after flashing different maps on our cars. It'll show up as a shadow code, and sometimes eventually it just goes away on its own. So I would suggest ignoring it. Again, if you're actually having a problem with your car or a check engine light, this is not causing your issue. Look at the other codes, and those will be a much better indicator of what's actually wrong with your car. So yeah, that's it for this video. Thank you guys for watching, and I hope this helps. And if you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below. Do.